Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 20th of 2019, well, it is titled Saturn at Night. So what do we see here? Well, a nighttime view of the planet Saturn, and something that we can never see from the Earth. In order to see from the nighttime view of Saturn, we have to be behind Saturn looking towards the sun. And from our position at the Earth, we're always looking outward. So we always see the daytime view of Saturn. So this is a view that is taken by the Cassini spacecraft that was orbiting around Saturn until about 2 years ago, when its mission ended and it was directed to plunge into the atmosphere. Now, one of the biggest things about Saturn that people always notice and talk about would be the ring system of Saturn. Now, the rings were actually first seen by Galileo back in the early 1600s. However, his smaller telescopes were unable to resolve them as rings, and it looked more like maybe Saturn had a pair of ears on it, a blob on either side. And of course, when they disappeared because they are so thin, that was also a big concern. It wasn't until several decades later that Christian Huygens saw them as rings and was able to come up with the idea that it was actually a ring, something not attached to Saturn itself. Now, the rings are divided into groups and they're labeled by letters. So we can see, for example, the A and the B ring labeled here, and they are separated by the Cassini division. Now, we mentioned this is taken by the Cassini spacecraft. They are both named after the same astronomer who had a powerful enough telescope to be able to pick out this division, this gap between the rings back in the later 1600s. So he got his name attached to the spacecraft that spent over a decade exploring Saturn, as well as to the gap between two of the main rings of Saturn. Now, the gap is actually an absence of particles, a place where there are fewer ring particles. Not none, there is still some structure, and in fact Cassini spacecraft has taken a deep look at this ring, and we can see that there is far more going on within these rings. You get some hint of structure looking at, for example, the B ring here. You can see lots of structure to it, alternating light and dark bands. So there is a lot more structure within these rings than we might have thought originally. And then furthest out, if you look out beyond the edge of the A ring, you can see the F ring. And the F ring is a very faint, thin ring confined by two shepherding satellites. So two small satellites that orbit around, one on the inside and one on the outside of this ring, and work as shepherds, confining the particles and keeping the particles in a very narrow ring like this. Now, we've talked about the A, B, and F rings. The C and D rings are much further in, close to Saturn and rather faint, as is the E ring much further out. So there are other rings there that are much fainter. The first, the A, B, and C are the ones that were actually discovered first and that can be seen from Earth. And the others were discovered later on and studied by the Cassini spacecraft. So here we can see those in a nighttime view of Saturn, something that we can never get from the Earth. And now that the Cassini spacecraft is actually a part of the planet and has plunged into its atmosphere, we cannot get this view again until another spacecraft travels out to Saturn. So that was our picture of the day for September the 20th of 2019. It was titled Saturn at Night. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be flowers in space. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.